the argument you make, and your opponent wrong, then where do you think a Justice Barrett would take the floor? President Trump, in this first segment, you go first, 2 minutes.
I will tell you very simply, we won the election. Elections have consequences. The American people have a right to have a say who the Supreme Court nominee is. And that say occurs when they vote for a United States senator and when they vote for the President of the United States. They're not going to get that chance now because we're in the middle of an election already. We're saying that Biden wanted to allow people to have private insurance still. They can. They do. They will under my proposal.
Not what you said, but and it's not what your party has said.
That is simply
your party doesn't say. Your party wants to go socialist medicine.
My party is
and
me.
Socialist
right
healthcare.
Now, I am
and they're
going to
dominate
party.
You, Joe. You know that.
I am the Democratic Party right now. The platform of the Democratic Party is what I, in fact, approved of. What I approved of. The president also is opposed to Roe v. Wade. That's on the ballot as well in the court. In the court. And so that's also at stake right now. And so the election is all...
You don't know it's on the ballot.
Why is it on the ballot?
Because
why is it on the ballot?
It's on the ballot in the court.
I don't think so.
In the court.
Well, there's nothing happening there.
Donald, we
and you don't know her view on Roe v. Wade.
I don't know.
You, in the course of these 4 years, have never come up with a comprehensive plan to replace Obamacare. And just this last Thursday... You signed a largely symbolic executive order to protect people with pre-existing conditions 5 days before this debate. So my question, sir, is what is the Trump health care plan?
Well, first of all, I guess I'm debating you, not him, but that's okay. I'm not surprised. Let me just tell you something. That there's nothing symbolic. I'm cutting drug prices. I'm going with favored nations, which no president has the courage to do because you're going against Big Pharma. Drug prices will be coming down 80 or 90%. You could have done it during your 47-year period in government, but you didn't do it. Nobody's done it.
Joe, you agree
with Bernie Sanders, the far left, on the manifesto,
manifest
you socialized medicine.
Look, hey, are you saying I'm not going to listen to him. The fact of the matter is, I beat Bernie Sanders.
Not by much.
I beat him a whole lot. I'm here standing facing
that was people. Fucking rigged.
Left 2 days early, you would have lost every problem.
All he knows how to do
Super
is
hurt. Tuesday. You got
Look,
very lucky.
Here's the deal. I got very lucky, and we get very lucky tonight as well. And tonight I'm going to make sure, because here's the deal. Here's the deal. The fact is that everything he's saying so far is simply a lie. I'm not here to call out his lies. Everybody knows he's a liar.
But you
I just
agree.
Want to make
you
sure. I want to make sure.
You graduated last in your class than the first in your class.
I want to make
Mr.
sure.
Mr. President, can you let him finish, sir?
No, he doesn't know how to do that. He is not for any help for people needing health care. Because he, in fact, already has cost 10 million people their health care that they had from their employers because of his recession. Number one. Number two, there are 20 million people getting health care through Obamacare now that he wants to take it away. He won't ever look you in the eye and say that's what he wants to do. Take it away.
No, I want to give you better health care at a much lower price because
Obamacare doesn't know how. He doesn't know how to do that.
I've already fixed it.
He has never offered a plan.
Fixed it to an extent.
He has
Obamacare,
never done a single
as you might
thing.
Know, but probably don't.
He has no plan for health care. He sends out wishful thinking. He has executive orders that have no power. He hasn't lowered drug costs for anybody. He's been promising a health care plan since he got elected. He has not, like almost everything else he talks about. He does not have a plan. He doesn't have a plan. And the fact is, this man doesn't know what he's talking about. You should get out of your bunker and get out of the sand trap and get in your golf course and go in the Oval Office and bring together the Democrats and Republicans and fund what needs to be done now to save lives.
So, if we would have listened to you...
Wait, 2 minutes, sir.
If we would have listened to you, the country would have been left wide open. Millions of people would have died, not 200,000, and one person is too much. It's China's fault. It should have never happened. They stopped it from going in, but it was China's fault. People that would not be necessarily on my side said that. President Trump did a phenomenal job. We did. We got the gowns, we got the masks, we made the ventilators. You wouldn't have made ventilators. And now we're weeks away from a vaccine. We're doing therapeutics already. Fewer people are dying when they get sick. Far fewer people are dying. We've done a great job. The only thing I haven't done a good job, and that's because of the fake news. No matter what you say to them, they give you bad press on it. It's just fake news. They give you good press, they give me bad press.
Yeah, fuck the media.
That's the way it is, unfortunately. But let me just tell you something. I don't care. I've gotten used to it. But I'll tell you, Joe, you could never have done the job that we did. You don't have it in your blood. You could have never done that job.
I know how to do the job. I know how to get the job.
Well, you didn't do very well in swine flu. H1N1, you were a disaster. Your own chief said you were a disaster.
14,000 people died, not 200,000.
There was no economic recession. You made a
point.
There was no recession.
You made a point.
And there was no one. We didn't shut down the economy. This is his economy. He shut down. If you believe for a moment what he's telling you, in light of all the lies he's told you about the whole issue relating to COVID, he still hasn't even acknowledged that he knew this was happening, knew how dangerous it was going to be back in February, and he didn't even tell you. He's on record as saying it. He panicked, or he just looked at the stock market. One of the two, because guess what? A lot of people died, and a lot more are going to die unless he gets a lot smarter, a lot quicker.
Mr. President?
Did you use the word smart? You graduated either the lowest or almost the lowest in your class. Don't ever use the word smart with me. And he wants to close down. He will shut it down again. He will destroy this country.
Holding large rallies with crowds packed together, thousands of people.
Outside,
yes, sir. Agreed. Vice President Biden, you are holding much smaller events with
nobody will show up.
People with
nobody gives a fuck.
Nobody shows up to his rally. We do them outside. We have tremendous crowds, as you see. I mean, and literally on 24 hours' notice. And Joe does the circles and has three people someplace.
Okay, all right.
And he's a fool on this.
If you could get the crowds, you would have done the same thing. But you can't. Nobody can.
We handed him a booming economy. He blew it.
It wasn't
booming.
It was the weakest recovery since It's all set up.
By Easter, this would be gone away. By the warm weather, it'd be gone. The racket's like a miracle. And by the way, maybe you could inject some bleach in your arm, and that would take care of it. This is the same thing.
That was said sarcastically.
And so here's the deal. He doesn't want to let me answer because he knows I have the truth. His position has been totally, thoroughly discredited.
By who? The media.
By everybody. Well, by the media, by our allies, by the World Bank,
President Trump, you have begun to increasingly question the effectiveness of masks as a disease preventer, and in fact, recently you have cited the issue of waiters touching their masks and touching plates. Are you questioning
You have to understand, if you look, I mean, I have a mask right here. I put a mask on it when I think I need it.
He has, in fact, worked on this in a way that he's going to be the first president of the United States to leave office, having fewer jobs in his administration than when he became president. Why does he want to open it up? Why doesn't he take care of the American? You can't fix the economy until you fix the COVID crisis. And he has no intention of doing anything about making it better for you all at home in terms of your health and your safety.
No, people want their schools open. They don't want to be shut down. They don't want their state shut down. They want their restaurants. I look at New York. It's so sad what's happening in New York. It's almost like a ghost town. And I'm not sure it can ever recover what they've done in New York. People want their places open. They want to get back to their lives.
People
They'll be careful,
be
but they want their schools open.
Okay.
I'm the one that brought back football. By the way, I brought back Big Ten football.
$750 a year in federal income tax each of those years. I know that you pay a lot of other taxes, but I'm asking you the specific question. Is it true that you pay $750 in federal income taxes each of those 2 years?
I paid millions of dollars in taxes.
Will you tell us how much you paid in federal income taxes in 2016 and 2017?
Millions of dollars.
You paid millions of dollars?
Millions of dollars.
So not $750.
Millions of dollars, and you'll get to see it. But
let
me just tell you, Chris, let me just tell you something, that it was the tax laws. I don't want to pay tax. Before I came here, I was a private developer. I was a private business people. Like every other private person, unless they're stupid, they go through the laws, and that's what it is. He passed a tax bill that gave us all these privileges for depreciation and for tax credits. We built a building and we get tax credits like the hotel on Pennsylvania Avenue. You get a massive, which by the way, was given to me by the Obama administration, if you can believe that.
He says he's smart because he can take advantage of the tax. And he does take advantage of the tax cuts. That's why I'm going to eliminate the Trump tax cuts. And we're going to eliminate those tax cuts and make sure that we invest in the people who, in fact, need the help. People out there need help.
But why didn't you do it over the last 25 years?
Because you were president. Because you weren't president screwing things up.
You were a senator.
You're the worst president America has ever had. Come on. I'm going to make the corporate tax 28%. It shouldn't be 21%.
If you ever became president with your ideas...
Worse than the Great Depression.
My taxes, I'll tell you what, you'll lose half of the companies that have poured in here will leave, and plenty
half
of companies that are already here, they'll leave for other places. They will leave, and you will have a depression, the likes of which you've never seen.
Final word.
Well, it's hard to get any word in with this clown.
China ain't your lunch, Joe, and no wonder your son goes in and he takes out billions of dollars to manage. He makes millions of dollars. And also, while we're at it, why is it, just out of curiosity, the mayor of Moscow's wife gave your son $3.5 million. What did he do to deserve it? What did he do with Barisma to deserve $180,000?
Hunter Biden's a piece of shit.
That's true. Not an answer.
None of that is true.
Oh, really? He did a very important
question.
He stood up.
No, the answer to the question is no.
Ukraine.
No, sir.
With $1 billion, if
that is absolutely not true.
You're doing it.
You're going to have
true.
Gentlemen. I hate to raise my voice, but as it seems to me, why should I be different than the two of you? Fewer interruptions. I'm appealing to you, sir, to do that.
Well, than him, too.
Well, frankly, you've been doing more interrupting than
that's all right, but he does plenty.
Well, Joe Biden's a liar.
Less than
dog-faced pony show liar.
The issue of race.
There's systemic injustice in this country, in education, in work, and in law enforcement, and the way in which it's enforced. But look, the vast majority of police officers are good, decent, honorable men and women. This man's done virtually nothing.
We believe in law and order, but you don't. The top 10 cities and just about the top 40 cities are run by Democrats and in many cases radical left. And they've got you wrapped around their finger, Joe. Democrats that run these cities don't want to talk like you about law and order. Are you in favor of law and order?
I'm in favor of law. You follow.
Are you in favor of law and order? Go ahead,
somebody. You ask a question, let him finish.
Law and order. Law and order with justice, where people get treated fairly. And the fact of the matter is, violent crime went down 17%, 15% in our administration. It's gone up on his watch.
Under
this president, we've become weaker, sicker, poorer, more divided, and more violent. He's racist.
But are you willing tonight to condemn white supremacists and militia groups and to say that they need to stand down and not add to the violence in a number of these cities, as we saw in Kenosha, and as we've seen in Portland? White supremacists and
Proud Boys, stand back and stand by, but I'll tell you what, somebody's got to do something about Antifa and the left, because this is not a right-wing problem. This is a left-wing problem.
That's what he is keep trying to rile everything up. He doesn't want to calm things down. Instead of going in and talking to people and saying, let's get everybody together, figure out how to deal with this. What's he do? He just pours gasoline in the fire. Nobody's going to build another coal-fired plant in America. No one's going to build another oil-fired plant in America. They're going to move to renewable energy, number one. Number two, we're going to make sure that we are able to take the federal fleet and turn it into a fleet that's run on their electric vehicles. Making sure that we can do that, we're going to put 500,000 charging stations and all of the highways that we're going to be building in the future. We're going to build an economy that, in fact, is going to provide for the ability of us to take 4 million buildings and make sure that they, in fact, are weatherized. My son was in Iraq. He spent a year there. He got the Bronze Star. He got the Conspicuous Service Medal. He was not a loser. He was a patriot, and the people left behind there were heroes.
Really?
And I resent
like hell.
I'm talking about my son, Bo Biden.
Talking about Hunter?
I don't know, Bo. I know Hunter. Hunter got thrown out of the military. He was thrown out, dishonorably discharged.
That's not true.
Cocaine use. And he didn't have a job until you became vice president. Once you
became
vice president, he made a fortune in Ukraine, in China, in Moscow, and various other places.
True.
Yeah, go fuck yourself.
My son.
And he didn't have a job.
My son, like a lot of people we know at home, had a drug problem. He's overtaken it. He's fixed it. He's worked on it. And I'm proud of him.
Science of climate change. And what will you do in the next 4 years to confront it?
I want crystal clean water and air. I want beautiful, clean air. We have now the lowest carbon. If you look at our numbers right now, we are doing phenomenally. But I haven't destroyed our businesses. Our businesses aren't put out of commission.
Do you believe that human pollution, gas, greenhouse gas emissions, contributes to the global warming of the planet?
I think a lot of things do, but I think to an extent, yes. But I also think we have to do better management of our forests. Every year, I get the call, California's burning. If that was cleaned, if you had forest management, good forest management, you wouldn't be getting those calls.
Pardon me?
You support?
No, I don't support the Green New Deal.
Oh, you don't? Oh, well, that's a big statement.
I support
that means you just the radical left.
I support the Biden plan that I put forward.
Rick your leaves and bag them, people of California. Smokey the Bear says you can prevent forest fires. Trump 2020 landslide clearly beat the fucking dog shit out of Joe Biden in this debate. Can go with premium bullet grips, refreshing and fucking delicious. Zero fucking door foam. Motherfuck Canada and fuck you, Fat Reggie. Doesn't matter how many Bangladesh Walmart t-shirts, American flag t-shirts you wear, Canadian to the fucking core, never will be a true American. No tour foam.